one had depression, and one had an eating disorder. So almost half the people. Well, take that number and apply it to every 13 to 18-year-old in the United States. According to the U.S. Department of Health and Human Services, 32% of 13 to 18-year-olds have anxiety, 13% have depression, and 3% have an eating disorder. Prior to the speech, I did research and read a lot of articles. So today I'm here to share with you the symptoms, causes, and effects of three common disorders in high school students: anxiety, depression, and eating disorders. Let's start with anxiety. Anxiety is defined as having excessive and uncontrollable worry and fear. According to the Mayo Clinic, there are over 10 specific types of anxiety, but all have similar symptoms. They include restlessness, feeling of impending danger, increased heart rate, hyperventilation, sweating, feeling weak, trouble focusing, poor sleep, and uncontrollable worry. While everyone can feel stressed or upset about a project or school assignment, people with anxiety experience 5 or more of these symptoms almost constantly for about 6 months at a time. In a 2018 study by Fatima Karani and Mitra Marodi to study the relationship between mental health and academic performance, they found that whether students were succeeding or failing in school really affected how poor their mental health was. And anxiety was among one of the top factors that got affected. Like anxiety, depression can also be brushed off as just a bad day or just a bad week. But according to a TED-Ed video by Harvard Medical School instructor Helen M. Perot, symptoms of depression can include low mood, loss of interest, changes in appetite, feeling worthless, poor sleeping, poor concentration, restlessness, loss of energy, and recurrent thoughts of suicide. Psychologists suggest that if you feel any of these symptoms, any 5 of these symptoms for 2 or more weeks, that you go and get a diagnosis. So, depression can affect students because it can lower their motivation to do work and make them feel like whenever they're doing their best, it's just not good enough. And in a 2018 study on the correlation of school burnout, anxiety, depression, and depression, Lachman-Cog and Ismail Thurser found that causes of depression could be poor relationships, low self-esteem, and trouble in school. And while scientists haven't found a specific cause for depression or for anxiety, most assume that it is a mix of genetics and environmental factors. So, depression can cause poor eating disorders, but more severe ones can crop up. Eating disorders fall into 3 categories: anorexia, bulimia, or binge eating. Crash Course Psychology episode 33 on YouTube defines anorexia as a starving diet and can result in a person having a low heart rate, muscle and bone weakness, severe dehydration, and being extremely underweight. Bulimia is defined as alternating between binge eating and purging, so changing between eating high-calorie foods and then either vomiting or using laxatives to maintain a steady weight. And while bulimia isn't as visually noticeable as anorexia, it can cause severe organ damage. Binge eating is defined as significant binge eating followed by emotional distress, feelings of disgust, and feelings of lack of control. The difference between binge eating and bulimia is that binge eating doesn't have any purging or fasting following the eating episodes. The National Institute of Mental Health says that eating disorders are caused by genetics, behavior, and psychological and social factors. Though most social factors are commonly going to be low self-worth and feeling the need to be perfect to meet the standards of others. Crash Course episode Psychology 33 says that eating disorders can cause extreme physical illnesses and medical conditions like pancreatitis and heart attacks at young ages. Out of all of the mental disorders, eating disorders are some of the most fatal because of the physical side effects that they can cause. So let's take a second to review. Anxiety is a mental disorder that is characterized by excessive worry. Depression can have symptoms ranging from poor sleep to feeling suicidal, and eating disorders fall under anorexia, bulimia, or binge eating. education has helped you learn that a lot of high school students are being affected by mental disorders, and that it's important that students recognize these factors and go and get help so that then they aren't affected negatively and end up hurting themselves. Thank you.